What most people outside of Wall Street and Washington don't know is that a lot of the people who bought these risky mortgage securities also went out and bought even more arcane investments that Wall Street was peddling, called credit default swaps. And they've turned out to be a much bigger problem. They are private and largely undisclosed contracts that mortgage investors entered into to protect themselves in case their investments went bad. Part of a huge unregulated market that's multiplied the losses. They've already helped bring down three of the biggest firms on Wall Street and threaten the ones that are left. But before your eyes glaze over, Michael Greenberger, a law professor at the University of Maryland and a former director of trading and markets for the Commodities Futures Trading Commission, says they're much simpler than they sound.
What is a credit default swap?
A credit default swap is a contract between two people, one of whom is giving insurance to the other that he will be paid in the event that a financial institution or a financial instrument fails.
So it's an insurance contract?
It is an insurance contract, but they've been very careful not to call it that, because if it were insurance, it would be regulated. So they use a magic substitute word called a swap, which by virtue of federal law is deregulated.
So anybody who was nervous about buying these mortgage-backed securities, these CDOs, they would be sold a credit default swap as sort of an insurance policy.
A credit default swap was available to them, marketed to them as a risk-saving device for buying a risky financial instrument.
But there was a problem.
Oh, there was a big problem.
What was the problem?
Well, the problem was that if it were insurance, or called what it really is, the person who sold the policy would have to have capital reserves to be able to pay in the case the insurance was called upon or triggered. But because it was a swap and not insurance, there was no requirement that adequate capital reserves be put to the side.
Now, who was selling these credit default swaps?
Bear Stearns was selling them, Lehman Brothers was selling them, AIG was selling them. You know, the names we hear that are in trouble, Citigroup was selling them.
These investment banks were not only selling the securities that turned out to be terrible investments, they were selling insurance on them?
Well, it made it easier to sell the terrible investments if you could convince the buyer that not only were they going to get the investment, but insurance.
But when homeowners began defaulting on their mortgages and Wall Street's high-risk mortgage-backed securities also began to fail, the big investment houses and insurance companies who sold the credit default swaps hadn't set aside the money they needed to pay off all the insurance contracts they'd written. Bear Stearns was the first to go under, selling itself to J.P. Morgan for pennies on the dollar. Then Lehman Brothers declared bankruptcy. And when AIG, the nation's largest insurer, couldn't cover its bad debts, the government stepped in with an $85 billion rescue.
What role did the credit default swaps play in this financial disaster?
They were the centerpiece, really. That's why the banks lost all the money. They lost all the money based on those side bets, based on the mortgages.
How big is the market for credit default swaps?
We really don't know. There's this voluntary survey that claims that the market is in the range of $50 to $60 trillion. It's sort of alarming that in a market that big, we don't even know how big it is to within, say, $10 trillion. But
$60 trillion?
$60 trillion. I know it seems incredible. It's four times the size of the U.S. debt, but that's the size of the market according to these voluntary reports.
And the market's totally unregulated.
And this market is almost entirely unregulated.
The result is a huge shadow market that may control our financial destiny, and yet the details of these private insurance contracts are hidden from the public, from stockholders, and from federal regulators. No one knows what they cover, who owns them, or whether or not they have the money to pay them off. One of the few sources of information is the International Swaps and Derivatives Association, a trade organization made up of the largest financial institutions in the world. Many of them are the very same companies that created the vast shadow market, lobbied to keep it unregulated, and are now drowning there because of unanticipated risks. The CEO, Robert Pickle, says there's nothing wrong with credit default swaps. The problem was the underlying mortgage securities.
Well, there's clearly something wrong with the system if all of these leveraged bets, hidden leveraged bets, caused a collapse in the financial system.
It is something that we all need to look at and learn lessons from, and we all need to work together to understand that in the future and design a structure in the future that works more effectively.
Yeah, my point is the people that made these mistakes are the people you represent in your organization, and many of them sit on the board. I mean, if they didn't get it right, who would?
These people understand the nature of these products.
Understand obviously the risks they didn't, or they wouldn't have bought them. They wouldn't have used them.
These are very useful transactions, and if people do understand the nature of the risks that they're entering into.
Well, if they're so useful, how come they brought down the financial system?
Because perhaps they didn't understand the underlying risk. Nobody really saw the effects that were going to flow through from the subprime lending situation.
That chapter is not over, and there is much suspense and fear on Wall Street that there are other big losses out there that have yet to be disclosed. They already dwarf what's been lost on those original risky mortgages. As bad as the mortgage crisis has been, 94% of all Americans are still paying off their loans. The problem is, Wall Street placed its huge bets and side bets with all those fancy securities on the 6% who are not.
We wouldn't be in any of this trouble right now if we had just had underlying investments in mortgages. We wouldn't be in any trouble right now.
It's all the side bets.
It's the side bets.
You've got all these big Wall Street firms, Bear Stearns, Lehman Brothers. You've got insurance companies like AIG. Merrill lost a ton of money on this. Everybody's lost a ton of money. They're supposed to be the smartest investors in the world, and they did it themselves.
They did it all on their own. That's the most incredible thing about this crisis, is that they pushed the button themselves. They blew themselves up.
Now, how much of this was just incompetence on the part of Wall Street, the people who ran it?
The truth is that on Wall Street, a lot of people just weren't very good at their jobs. It's as simple as that.
These people were being paid $50 to $100 million a year. Some of them, the guys that were running the places.
There is no defending a trainee making $45,000 a year would have had the common sense not to bet the firm on mortgage contraptions that no one in the firm actually understood. That is not a deep point to comprehend. Somehow, through, I will call it, a criminal neglect and incompetence, the people at the top of these firms chose to look away, to take more risk, to enrich themselves, and to put the shareholders, and indeed the country itself, ultimately the country's economy, at risk. And it is truly not only a shame, it's a crime.
We requested interviews with top executives at Bear Stearns, Lehman Brothers, Merrill Lynch, Morgan Stanley, Goldman Sachs, and AIG. They all declined.